Boom shakalaka, this Bitcoin fractal is playing out perfectly. Why Bitcoin price could 10x end the altcoin signal that has never failed. Stay tuned. What's up everyone, Randall here from Crypto Love. Today's video, a lot of very interesting charts for Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies, including Bitcoin could 10x and altcoin signals firing off. Before we get into it, guys, like the video, it helps out a lot. Come join us on Twitter at The Crypto Love, and of course, subscribe to the channel if you haven't. Now, fear and greed today at 79, in extreme greed, down from yesterday's 84, but still extreme greed for the past week, and above greed for the past month. Pretty exciting. The overall market up 1.5% today. Bitcoin right now, 69. Way to go, Bitcoin. 69,179, just around previous all-time highs. Let's hope Bitcoin price hangs here for like a month. I mean, I'm sure most of you don't, but it's at 69,000. I mean, come on. Ethereum at 39.41, BNB at 489, Solana 148, XRP 62 cents, Cardano 74 cents, Dogecoin 17 cents, and Shiba 4 zeros and a 3. Now, Bitcoin, ever since we posted this fractal of the last time when Bitcoin encountered $20,000 previous resistance, we put this fractal here. Bitcoin price went down exactly like this said. This predicted, of course, 57.9, and it only went to 59, so not exact. But then bounced back up. Right now, March 10th, same time frame, we are looking at it once again touching the previous all-time high. Now, based on this, it does get rejected a second time, going all the way down to roughly 62,000 by March 20th, before eventually breaking through that $69,000-$70,000 barrier by the end of March, right around March 25th. Now, will this exact same thing happen? No, we also do have this nice little triangle right here that generally breaks to the upside, could break a lot faster, especially if there is momentum pushing it that way. What momentum? Well, this momentum right here, 7,000 Bitcoin per day, net inflow to ETFs. Fidelity records its highest day ever. Look at this, 7,000, yowza. While Grayscale sees continued outflows, and BlackRock kind of takes a pause after a gigantic buy on Tuesday. But we are still seeing 7,000 Bitcoin net inflows. Mind you guys, over the course of a year, that's 2 million Bitcoin, which is more Bitcoin than is available on all the exchanges. So keep that in the back of your mind. Right now, Coinbase, Bitcoin spot trading volume going through the roof, and Coinbase, and we haven't even broken all-time highs. So people want Bitcoin now. It's easier than ever to get right now. Stay tuned till the end for the case why Bitcoin could potentially 10x. We are seeing right now a decrease of Bitcoin inventory on exchanges, which would be this blue line right here, spot Bitcoin. And then also we're seeing a decrease in the paper and spot Bitcoin. So last cycle, a lot of spot or paper spot Bitcoin was created, which caused a little bit of the price crash. The flood of paper Bitcoin seen in the last cycle is now receding. This is bullish as both of these decrease as we're seeing them eaten up by a lot of these ETFs. Well, price is going to continue going higher. Is it a surprise that we're seeing the pump starting so early? Maybe not. Maybe the cycle is not due to the halving. Maybe it's due to the global liquidity signal we can see right here that every time it breaks through this line here on the stock RSI, that has basically been the impulse for roughly 6 bars on the 2-month candles or roughly 1 year to a peak. So it could be within a year of the new cycle peak. That's exciting for you, for me, for everybody. But the good news is we're nowhere near that peak as of this moment. The realized cap last 200 days as a percent of total is showing we're only about 20% of the way towards a peak. So that being said, there's still a lot of room to go. And this chart also echoes this as a proof of work incentives and long-term holder supply right now. Barely bouncing off of the bottom, not until we get way up to the top do we ever see the peaks. So we're just getting started and already approaching previous all-time highs. Right now, based on this bullish megaphone pattern that Bitcoin is forming, it would seem like $98,000 is the next stop, and it probably is not going to rest until we reach it, especially after breaking through these previous resistance levels that Bitcoin saw 3-4 years ago, there's clear skies ahead, nothing but up territory. So where does that leave us? The most impulsive bull run in history? Yes. This cycle, we've talked about this a few other times this week, this cycle actually is different. There's a lot of things about this cycle that's different from previous cycles. This one actually is different. Bitcoin is finally on the world's stage, finally approved by some of the largest governments in the world. And we see some charts that have long-term time frames and or first-time ever crosses happening, like this one right here, the weekly MA 100 and 200 in for the first ever bullish cross. This could be one of the biggest bull runs we could ever see. Historically, when there has been a narrowing, there has been an explosive bull run afterwards. We not only had a narrowing here, we also had a crossing, meaning that we could have a huge, absolutely huge bull run coming. As a matter of fact, Willy Wu chimes in here. He says that back here in July 2010, Bitcoin was 0.7 cents. It popped 10x in 5 days and then another 1,000x 2 years following. Why? Bitcoin was introduced to global liquidity with the advent of Mt. Gox. And you're saying, well, who the heck cares? Listen, Bitcoin just got listed on the world's stock markets, which holds $100 trillion of capital, and they are piling in. In case you forgot how quickly they're piling in, look at it right here, buying up more Bitcoin than is available within a year's time. So that being said, there is the possibility, with all this capital piling in, Bitcoin maybe could 10x. Right now it's got, what, a $1.3 trillion market cap? There's $100 trillion in capital. If people put 10% of the capital of the stock markets into Bitcoin, that would easily be a 10x of Bitcoin price. And that's without the FOMO, the frenzy, all of that. But the even better news is that as Bitcoin goes up, so do altcoins. We have very strong evidence for alt season about to start. The past week with meme coins, with gaming coins now, we're starting to see them pop. This is evidence that alt season is beginning, which is great because after it begins, it goes up for a long, long time. Crypto alt season has officially started while Bitcoin dominance is hitting resistance. You can see this resistance line on Bitcoin dominance right here. You can see that we are in for massive alt season coming up. As a matter of fact, the golden cross of the Gunnar EMA has finally happened on the monthly charts. And we also had this double bottom right here. So all of this suggesting we are in for a massive alt season coming up. As a matter of fact, this signal has never failed. I think this is a log D cross right here. But historically, this has called massive, massive alt season. So all of those things are looking good for Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies. If you enjoyed it, push the like button, subscribe to the channel. I'll catch you guys later. Have a good one. Love you. Peace.
If you don't think Bitcoin's going to $1 million a coin and then $10 million a coin, you're already a loser.
From now on, if you don't own Bitcoin, you're a moron.